everyone. This is a case of 62 years postmenopausal bleeding, and clinically it was found to be a CA cervix 3 cm lesion in ectocervix infiltrating, and HP was sent, and the HP came to be adenosquamous carcinoma, and the MRI was done, and the bilateral parametrium was normal, UV space was normal, and the plan is for the open radical hysterectomy because of some low vitality of the patient, and for other reason because this is stage 1B2 lesion, we didn't get a consent for the laparoscopic procedure. So obviously this is an open radical hysterectomy. Here the incision should be a longitudinal and adequate incision. Second, while opening the peritoneum, we must go lateral to the bladder, otherwise if we'll go straight down, then there is every chance that we can open the peritoneum. The third step, important step, is the proper packing of the bowel, which is most important. As in this case, we have packed serially. Then one copper plate wrapped up with the towel is given so that the bowel will not come to the field. First, few people go for the lymphadenectomy, few for the hysterectomy. It doesn't matter. We practice the hysterectomy after assessment of the lymph node clinically. And this is the opening of the left lateral space. And first we cut down the round ligament, then we can cut the infundibular pelvic ligament. Of course, in the laparoscopy, last step is to cut the infundibular pelvic ligament because it stabilizes the uterus. But here in the open surgery, we can have the liberty of stabilizing that, so you can take. Then you hold the medial fold of the peritoneum. Then first thing is to find out the ureter, which is obviously in the medial fold of the peritoneum. This is the ureter. And after ureter dissection, you can go to the UV space opening and UV space, uterovesicle space creation and opening of the uterovesicle space. And this is a completely avascular space unless we hit any vein of the bladder and the cervicovesical ligament. Then we can go for the other side lateral space opening. We can cut down the round ligament. Then after the round ligament, the infundibular pelvic ligament is approached. We are using vessel sealer. It is from the Covidian. And this is a small jaw with the shearer. This is the right infundibular pelvic ligament. Then after it, the right side ureter is searched for, then dissected. Then the creation of the lateral pararectal space, then the lateral paravesical space. In between, there is the demarcating margin, the uterine artery. This is the uterine artery, which is ligated at its origin of the right side. Then we can cut the uterine artery. Then we can dissect the uterine artery. Then we can dissect through the uterine tunnel, ureteric tunnel. Either we can use the sealer or we can divide and have a tie with the silk or the vicryl, doesn't matter. This is making up the right side ureteric tunnel. Some veins used to be there here, both in anterior and the posterior, that is the deep uterine vein, and the veins present in the cervicovesical ligament. This is in the left side creation of the, this is the medial pararectal space, this is the lateral pararectal space, then the uterine artery. Uterine artery, in fact, is the boundary between the paravesicle and the pararectal space. Anteriorly, the paravesicle space, and the posteriorly, the pararectal space. This is the uterine artery. From its origin, it is coagulated properly and divided. Then you can hold the uterine artery. Always take care of the veins because they used to bleed and the field is spoiled rather. This is right side ureteric tunnel. This educational video is just to give the glimpse of the different steps followed for the radical hysterectomy. This is the creation of the rectovaginal space. This is an avascular space. There occurs some bleeding because that was a wrong plane. The plane was approached a bit above. It should have been approached below. Some veins were teared up. That's why the bleeding, but not that is not much alarming. Then dissection of the peritoneum. Again, further dissection of the UV space as a second step. We can go to get an adequate amount of vagina. This second step dissection is necessary. The uterovesical space. Here there are few veins used to be there, and this is the right side McInerney's ligament. Here care must be taken to address good amount of the parametrium. As much as possible, lateral clamp has to be put up so that a good amount of the parametrium. This is the right side uterosacral ligament. This is the right side uterosacral ligament. And this is the ureter. This is the medial pararectal space. Then once the medial pararectal space and the rectovaginal space is formed, the structure in between is the uterosacral ligament. Then uterosacral ligament is coagulated and divided. Here then after lateralization of the ureter, left side, this is a part of the tunnel. Care must be taken not to hit the ureter through the energy source. And this is the lateralization of the ureter so that good amount of the parametrium can be achieved. This is the parametrium that we are liberating or achieving. We have lateralized the ureter, so it's almost type 3 radical hysterectomy in the old version or the type C in the new version or new nomenclature. Then this is the paracalpus area, right side paracalpus area. Then on the other side paracalpus and the opening of the vagina. The opening of the vagina can be done with the monopolar seizures or even the bipolar cutting elements. So few things should be addressed properly. One is parametrium, second is the adequate vaginal length, third is the proper retrieval of the all the lymph nodes, draining lymph nodes from the pelvis. These are the three things should not be missed in a case of radical hysterectomy. We prefer to keep the vagina open. We take the purse-string sutures all around. Then we keep the middle part. Here some amount of the vagina can be taken more so that again we dissected. We can take out the vagina after dissection, the posterior vagina and the anterior vagina was dissected further to take a bit of more vagina. This is the anterior. The anterior vagina further dissected and cut. The locking suture in a the vagina is kept open to have the collection out from that side. is a regular practice for last more than 10 years we are doing without any problem and without any much of the lymphocyst formation. Maximum we used to give a vaginal drain through that for 2 to 3 days. Otherwise, we don't give any negative drain Romovac in the pelvis. And in our practice, the lymphocyst formation is not that significant. Then the lymphadenectomy, this is the left side lymphadenectomy, this is the lower group of the external iliac lymph nodes. This is the bipolar shearer. Same as laparoscopic shearer. This is of course the hand instrument. So the structure just in front is the artery, then the bluish color is the vein. Then the upper external iliac group of the lymph nodes. There are 5 groups of the lymph nodes are removed. One is lower external iliac, upper external iliac, common iliac, obturator group of the lymph nodes in from the obturator fossa, then the internal iliac group of the lymph nodes. This is the common iliac group of the lymph nodes. Care must be taken not to injure the veins, common iliac vein which is medial to the artery in the left side. This is the obturator fossa. This is the obturator group of the lymph node. Here the lowermost part is the corona mantis. The lateral boundary is the external iliac vein. The medial boundary is the obliterated umbilical artery or the ligament, you can say. And the upper border is the joining of the external and the internal iliac vein. Ideally, we should not go beyond the corona mantis, the vein joining the external iliac vein to the internal iliac vein. That is the corona. Look at the vein is visible, just beautiful vein. And the posteriormost boundary is the obturator nerve. Because beyond the obturator nerve, the internal iliac vein used to be there. So to avoid injuring to the internal iliac vein, we always teach to the students that never go beyond the obturator nerve. Once the obturator nerve is reached, there are no nodes beyond that. So better not to go there. Unnecessarily you will hit the internal iliac vein. Once the internal iliac vein is hit, there will be profuse bleeding will be there, and there will be cascade of the complications will be there. So it is better to avoid to injure the internal iliac vein. This is the internal iliac group of the lymph node, left side. This is the nerve, just save from the nerve, SHAV is save. Small veins used to be there. In this plane, there used to be obturator vein. Sometimes the obturator vein used to be torn off if you are not careful. The obturator vein used to be a superficial one. It traverses along with the nerve. Then there's some nodes which are present in between the artery and the vein. Those are the external iliac group of the nodes can be removed. These are between the artery and the veins. all the lymph nodes should be removed. And it is better to use some energy source so that there will be less chance of the lymphuria and the lymphocyst formation. If you will use the seizures dissection, then there is more chance of the formation of the lymphocyst because all the lymph channels will be remain open and there is chance. Present between the artery and the vein. This is the right side, external iliac, group of the lymph node. There used to be a constant feeder vessel to this external iliac group of the lymph nodes. Sometimes while taking, there used to be a bleeding sometime. And just coagulation of those bleeders will suffice, nothing to worry. Just create the boundary first, all around, then go for the dissection. This is the obliterated umbilical, the medial boundary. You can use conventional bipolar. Also, even monopolar can be used. It depends on the expertise. If you are using monopolar, the current delivery must be as minimum as possible. This is the obturator group of the lymph node removed. This is the internal iliac group of the lymph node. The obturator nerve is exposed. Look at the obturator vein, which is very much in front of us. Obturator vein. Then we can go for the common iliac group of the lymph node. Common iliac vein used to be lateral to the common iliac artery of the right side. The artery, common iliac artery, just passes above the common iliac vein, then gets lateral. These are the structure displayed. This is the corona mantis, this is the circumflex vein. This is the nerves, iliangular nerve, genitofemoral nerve. This is the right side, external iliac artery, vein, obturator nerve, obturator vein. Obliterated umbilical and the ureter. So that finishes the operation, and always ensure the hemostasis and take out all the mops or the tetra which are within, and then close the abdomen properly with the sutures, otherwise the patient will turn up with the hernia. Her disease will be cured, but the hernia will be there. So proper closure is an ensurement that should be there. Thank you everybody for watching this video. Thank you all.